In this vlog, we will see how to use shared preference in Flutter. Shared preference is a form of storing data in your application. So it's a temporary storage option available. This is mostly used to store user credentials and also lightweight data. So here we need to add a dependency, shared preferences, and the version is 0.5.8 is the current version. When you are trying this, please check the latest version and add it to your prospect. And when we get into the code, here you can see we have declared a local storage variable. It's nothing but a shared preference as we have discussed. So here we are initializing the shared preference object, and thereafter we are creating a design. So the design consists of two fields, one is email ID and the another one is password. And here if you get into the details, for the email ID we have specified the style of text style, font bold and font size, everything. And here we have specified a controller. So in the starting of the code we have specified two controllers here. So what is the use of a controller? So whenever you are trying to fetch the data from an input field, we use these controllers. So if you have entered some data into a particular input field, for example here we have used email ID, so here with the help of this controller we can fetch the data out from the input field. So how we fetch is a simple way. You mention your controller here dot text to string. So in this way we can fetch the data from input field using a controller. So here we are having two input fields, so we are specifying two controllers here, email and password controller. And in the text field tag, specify the controller here so that you can find that particular input field and fetch the exact data of it. So here, other than that, we are having obscure text option. So what is an obscure text? So whenever you are trying to enter a password, so you want to cover the text, right? So here we are specifying obscure text. So for email ID there is no need, so we have specified false here. And when comes to password, we are specifying it as true. So this is the decoration we have provided to the input field, and it is completely optional for you. You may use or you may not. So depending upon your screen design requirements, you may use these additional options. And when we get into the shared preference, here we have specified a button. So whenever you have entered the username and password and you need to save, right? So we have specified a button which will take up the task of saving your credentials. And we have specified the name for the button. So when you click on the save button here, it's an asynchronous way of storing your emails, ID and password. So here we are initializing our shared preference, and thereafter we are storing our credentials here. And whenever you come back to the screen again, the credentials are being displayed here using a text widget. So here we are checking whether the local storage is not equal to null, and thereafter we are printing the details onto the user screen in this scenario. So here this is the basic example of shared preferences. Let us see the output of how the shared preferences is stored. So here on the screen you can see the design we have developed, and I am trying to store some user credentials. Okay, so now we will try to save the user details. So clicking on the login, our shared preference will be stored. And let us try to refresh the screen. Here you can see these are the details we have stored in our shared preference. So this is the email ID and this is the password, and it is showing that the details are saved. So it is a basic example of a shared preference we are showing in this tutorial. And if you have any issues in this particular tutorial, do let us know in our comment section below. And the code for this tutorial is available in the description section below. And you can append this particular example according to your own requirements. And if you face any problem in that particular case, also let me know in the comment section below. And for more interesting tutorials like this on Flutter, do like, share, and subscribe to our channel.